There we go. We're going to stand nice and tall, tummy muscles in, shoulders down and back. We're going to go head turns, side and side. Good. Head forward, ear to the shoulder. Good. Big shoulder circles up, around, and back. Couple more. Good. We're going to a march or a low jog. Up to you. Little quicker if you can. Three, two, one. Step apart. Big arm circles back. Stretch your energy through your fingertips. Good tall posture. Other side. Hands together, let's rock. Go ahead into your X and your Y. X and Y. One more. Hold it up there. Pull it down for your W. Reach Y to W. Big squeeze of those shoulder blades. Chest is open. Good. Cross it in front. Kick back. Good squeeze right between your shoulder blades.
About you. You're imperfectly perfect. Everyone's itching for beauty, but you're scratching the surface. Lost time is never found. Can you DJ please reverse it? It's like we paid for change.
Three.
A second worth it.
Two. One. Turn it into a grapevine. Cross it over.
Some battles, but love wins in the end. You shine just like the sun while the moon and the stars reflect your light. Beauty revolves around you. So you like that?
All right, we're going to turn it into a little quick side step or shuffle. Either quick little steps like this or a shuffle. Up to you. Quick little steps or a shuffle. Good. Let's go into a walking march, high march. Good. Buck kickers behind ya. Good. Turn it into a heel toe walk. Heel toe, heel toe, heel toe. Good. One more little lap. Head up and relax. All right. So for part one of our workout, we're going to start with three exercises. You can take a heavier set of weights for these exercises if you want to. We're going to hold our weights by our side like this. We're going to start with a reverse lunge. You can also do these without weights altogether or a lighter set of weights. Up to you. lunge. We're going to step back for a big step, bend our knees, push through our front heel, squeeze our tush, and stand tall. Switch sides. It can be very small motion that you go down right here and push and squeeze, or it can be much larger. It doesn't matter. You can, you know, do it based on your stability and how you're feeling, but you want to focus on that big push through your front heel, squeeze your tush. Whether it's small or large, that's going to help you get that good stability. Exercise two, we're going to go into a bent row. So we're going to get into that narrow stance. Sit our hips back. We're going to alternate. One pull, second pull. Big squeeze right between our shoulder blades and alternate there. Exercise three, we're going to go for a deadlift motion. Same narrow stance. Weights are in front of my thighs. I'm going to sit my hips back. So I'm bending my knees a little bit, but I'm pretending like someone has pulled my tail. So my hips are going way back. And then they're shooting forward, squeeze my tush. If you want to make that exercise harder, you can go one-sided. So I will put down one weight, and I will put my toes up on one side, and I'll hold my weight in that side. Now I'm going to turn to the side so you can see from the side. I'm going to reach across, stick my hips back, and stand tall. So it's still the same motion. I'm just putting as light pressure as I can on these toes, stick my hips back, and come up tall. Stick my hips back, and come up tall. You can make this one step harder if you want to, and kind of touch back and forth. Touch back and forth. But you really need to think about not the touch part, the hips part. You really need to think about you're still maintaining that same deadlift motion where you're focusing on the hips going back and the hips shooting forward. Everybody feel comfortable with those exercises? Yeah. Awesome. All right. We'll get started here. We're going to start with that reverse lunge. Get my weights. We will get started here in just a second. Three, two, one. Go ahead. Step back. Big push through. And you can lean forward just slightly. You don't have to be totally upright. But either one works. You can be slightly forward or all the way upright. Big push through that heel. Squeeze your tush. Really working our glutes on this exercise. We'll get some quads too, balance, core. 5 more seconds. And relax. Good. We're going into our bent row here next. Take a little breather. Sit those hips back. Nice straight back. And here we go. Big pull. Big pull. And you want those elbows to come just past the side of your body, not too far past. Good. One and then the other. Big squeeze of your shoulder blade right to the center of your body. Good. Tuck those elbows in close to your body. Good. 10 more seconds. Three. And relax. Good. We're going into our deadlift motion here next. If you're going one-sided, you're holding one weight, and you're putting that weight in the side that your toes are up on. We'll get started in five. Here we go. Hips go back. Press them forward. Hips go back. Press them forward. Good squeeze of your tush. big focus on the back side of our body here for part one. Good. Looks nice. Good. If you're doing that one-sided, make sure those hips go back. 5 more seconds. And relax. Good. We're going back to our reverse lunge. We'll grab both of our weights. Good tall posture here to start. Getting started in 5. Here we go. Step back, big push. Step back, big push. Good. Remember on this one, the majority of your weight stays on your front leg. Your back leg on this one is just like a kickstand. Good. Good. Big squeeze. 10 more seconds. And relax. Good. We're going into our bent row here next, alternating sides. Start to sit those hips back. Back is nice and straight. Here we go. Big pull. Big pull. Right to the side of your body. Good. Big squeeze of that shoulder blade right to the center. Keep those shoulders low. Low squeeze. Good. Ten more seconds. And relax. Good. We're going for our deadlift motion. If you did one side, we'll switch sides. Getting ready. We got 5 seconds. Here we go. Good. Good. Don't step back if you're doing that deadlift. Just let those hips sit back, then push them forward. Good. Good. Good big squeeze of your tush as you stand nice and tall. Less than 10 more seconds. And relax. Good. We got one more round of these before we switch it up. So we're back to our reverse lunge. Getting started in 3. Here we go. Step back. Big push. Big push. Nice and tall in between. Perfect posture each time. Finish that motion. Gets a good motion of our glutes. Good postural muscles. Excellent weight bearing for our hips. Ten more seconds. And relax. Good. Going into our bent row here next. Sitting those hips back. Getting ready. Here we go. Big pull. Big pull. Head is right in line with your body. Getting that good posture. later. Good. Just don't go too far past the side of your body. 10 more seconds. 5. And relax. Good. Last one on our deadlift. If you're doing singles, I'll tell you when to switch because we're only going to do it this last time here. So I'll tell you to switch halfway. Or you could finish it out with double. Up to you. Getting started in 5. Here we go. Hips go back. Press them forward. Good. We got 5 seconds if you're switching for halfway. That's halfway. More seconds. And relax. Good. Very nice. All right, take a breather. Grab a sip of water if you need it. Talk you through the next part. We've got 4 parts today. They're a little shorter, a little mixing it up. So the next part, what we're going to do is we're going to grab one weight, and it can be a lighter weight. So depends on how you're feeling with your body. I'll demonstrate the motions, but it can be a lighter weight if you want, because you're using this one weight, and we're kind of flowing through 4 exercises without much stop. We're just going to go from one to the next. We're going to be doing 5 repetitions. For each exercise, we have 4 exercises, and we're just going to go through those on one side of our body, and then go through those on the other side of our body, and then repeat. Hopefully, we're going to get through it twice. You might get through it a little bit more. I'm going to put a timer on, and so we're going at our own pace for this one, this little mini section in the middle. I'll put a timer on. We're going at our own pace. You do it as many rounds as it fits for you. But I'll demonstrate. So what we're going to do is you can either start with that bent row right here, same position like this, pull back for 5 reps, or you can get into a really wide stance here like this, put your forearm here, and go for this kind of row. It just gets a little deeper and a little bit more. It's up to you and how your body feels. So you're doing 5 repetitions of your bent row. Then you're going to stand up. Put that weight right in front. You're going to do 5 repetitions of a push press. We go for a little dip in our knees and a big push overhead. A little dip in our knees and a big push overhead. You can kind of pause it at the top and slowly bring it down so you can kind of control the speed on that one. Otherwise, it gets a little quick. But you're going for 5 repetitions. Then you're going to put it in front of your body. You can either hold it with one hand like this, or 2 if you need the support. We're going for a side lunge. So side lunge for 5 repetitions, and I'll walk us through this all. And then you're gonna do 5 repetitions of a swing. So you're gonna hold it with both hands, end of the dumbbell like this. You're going to let your arms just go for the ride. This is a hip motion. It's going to look like it's an arm motion, but it's a hip motion. What I want to do is bend my hips back to start. So kind of like that football height, kind of reaching through my legs motion, holding tight onto my dumbbell. Don't let it go. Let those hips go back and shoot them forward. And my arms just naturally swing because my hips are going back and shooting forward. The goal is that each time I give a good squeeze of my tush and press my hips forward, and that just lets my arms kind of float through, but it's a hip motion. So we're going for 5 swings, then you start on your second side. So you go big row, push press, side lunge, swing. Make sense? Everybody feel okay? Good. All right, I'll set my timer. We're just doing this for 3 minutes. So It's really just however many times you get through it, but the goal is to try to get through it each side twice. All right, ready? We're going to start with that bent row, then you go push press. Ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Bent row. Then you go for your push press. Then you go for your side lunge, one arm or two. Big push away on your side lunge. Then you go for your swing. So both hands, hips go back, press them forward. Hold it tight. Really push those hips forward. Then we switch sides. So then we go back to our row. Then we go to our push press. Then we go to our side lunge, one arm or two. Then you go to your swing. Then we go back to our row when you're ready. Then back to your push press. Then back to your side lunge when you're ready. One hand or two. Then back to your swing. Little flow here in the middle. Then other side. Row. Then push press. You take your time. Go through it as you need to. Then side lunge. Then swing. Then we're done. Good. Once you've got it, take a breather, grab a quick sip of water. We'll go on to the next section. Next section, we're going to pick it up for a little cardio burst. We're going to go for 3 exercises. We're going to go for our jacks, either touch out jacks or regular jacks, or if you want to go arms low jacks, that's up to you. We're going to go for cherry pickers, where we're going opposite arm and leg march. You can add a heel raise here if you want, or even a little tiny hop if you want. Keep those knees soft. And the third one is a little backboard tap or a little jog in place, whatever you're comfortable with. A little soft jog in place. Or backboard taps are where we're reaching up and we're trying to do teeny tiny hops, keeping our knees soft. Okay? Everybody feel comfortable with those exercises? Let's get it. Switch up my timer here real quick. Here we go. Oops, hold on. Almost. All right, ready? Starting with those jacks. In 3, 2, 1, go. Little cardio burst here in the middle of our workout. No matter what I do, I'm no good without you. And I can't Doing great. And relax. Take a little breather. We're going to go for our cherry pickers next. Opposite arm and leg march. You decide if it has a heel raise or a hop. Here we go. You can get some momentum going with your arms. Big swings. 10 more seconds. Relax. Going for our little jog or our back forward taps here next. Here we go. Ready? Go ahead. Little jog or little taps. Soft knees either way. Deep breathe in. 10 more seconds. And relax. Back to our jacks. Take a breather. Here we go. Ready? Go ahead. Ten more seconds. Five more seconds. And relax. Going for our cherry pickers next. Here we go. Good. Keep up your pace. So keep calm, honey. I must stick around for more than a minute. Get used to it. Bunny, my name. And relax. Good. Going for our back forward taps or our little dog here again. Swish, swish, bish. Here we go. Keep it going. You should retire. You found as cute as an old coupon expired. 5 seconds. And relax. Good. Take a breather. We're going back to our jacks. One more round. I think. Here we go. Back to our jacks. We're going to finish off with some arms today, so. Five more seconds. And relax. Good. Back to our cherry pickers. Getting that heart rate going a little bit. Here we go. Big reach, big swing. What's going on with the song? Keep going, keep going, keep going. Pink Ferragamo lighters on. Keep going. 10 more seconds. Talking in my sleep at night, making myself crazy. And relax. Good. Back to our back forward tap or jog. Last one here in our little cardio burst. Here we go. Last one. Give it what you got. 20 more seconds. Give it a little burst if you can. Ten more seconds. And relax. Good. Excellent work. Take a little breather. Grab a sip of water if you need it. We'll get ourselves set for the next part. My timer is complete. All right, so part four, technically, of our workout today, we're going to go for some wall push-ups and do some arms. So if you have a spot of wall or an elevated surface, we're going to do some wall push-ups. So I'm going to show you on the bar here first. I'm going to go up against the bar, walk my body back into that big plank position. I want to think about my elbows coming down at a 45-degree angle by my body, pushing my body away. I'm keeping my shoulders nice and low, not scrunching them up, but lowering my body in as much as I can towards my chest and then pushing away. So that's exercise one. Exercise two, you're going to take a weight. It could be a lighter weight if you want. You're going to hold the ends. You're going to press it straight overhead. Straight overhead, arms are by your ears. You're going to march, big march, holding that weight straight up. Overhead, keeping your core muscles in. Exercise three, we're going to take our triceps. We're going to pull those back like we're doing our row. Kick back straight and control it in. Big push, control it in. Big push, control it in. Next exercise, I'm set up in a really bad position to do this one, but we're going to do our Sphinx push-ups. Those are the ones where we put our forearms against the wall. And then we push through our palms and press away. If you're not in a good spot for that one, you can certainly go back to just the regular push-ups and do those again. We're going to do them kind of in a row, so it's up to you on that one, but it's not super long. All right. Everybody feel comfortable with those exercises? Yeah. All right. Let's get going. We're going to start with those wall push-ups first. Okay. Here we go. We're getting started here in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Lowering your body in, pushing away. Good. Elbows are down. Good. Looks great. Bend those elbows as much as you can and then big push away. Good. Good. Keep going. You've got 10 more seconds. If you need a break, feel free to take the break. We've got 5 more seconds. And relax. Good. We're going into our overhead press with our march here next. Make sure your space is clear. Grab that weight. We'll be pressing it right overhead as high as we can. Okay, weight goes up. And big march, big march, big march. Tuck your core in. Try to keep as tall posture as you possibly can. Getting the stability through those hips, your core, working the shoulder strength as we hold that weight overhead. Keep breathing. Good. Couple more seconds. And relax. Good. We're going for our triceps here next. Sit those elbows, hips back. Pull those elbows back. We'll get started in 3. Here we go. push back, control it in. Big push, should feel it right behind your arms. Good, not so far, Chris. Tuck those elbows in. Keep the elbows by your body the whole time. Excellent. Good, 10 more seconds. And relax, good. We're going for those Sphinx push-ups next. That's where our whole forearm and hands are against the wall. We push our palms away and then we control it as we come back in. So forearms and hands are against the wall. Ready, go ahead. Push through your palms, straighten your arms, and then control it to lower your elbows and forearms back to the wall. Good. You could lower your hands down just a little bit, Chris. Be a little more comfortable for you. Good. Keep it going. You got 10 more seconds if you can. And relax. Good. Take a breather. We're going to our regular push-ups here next. Regular wall push-ups here next. We're getting started in 5 seconds. Here we go. Lower in, big push away. Lower in, big push away. Check on you. Keep going. Good. Looks good. Big push through those arms. Big breath out as you push. Breathe in on the lower. Big breath out. Good, 10 more seconds. Good, relax. We're going into our overhead press with our march here next. Take a breather. We're almost done. I know, the burner here at the end. Five seconds, we're gonna get started. You can bring that weight up, nice and high. Core is in, big, tall marches. Good, keep breathing, keep your core in. Focus on being as tall as you can be. Keep those arms up as high as you can. And relax. Good. We're going to finish it off with the triceps one time and then we'll stretch. All right. Sit those hips back. Pull those elbows back. Here we go. Big press. Bring it in. Big press. Bring it in. Head is nice and neutral. Elbows are tucked. Good. If you want a little burner, we'll hold it here at the end. I'll tell you when. If you really want to wear those arms out, hold them back. Good squeeze. Extend them straight. Hold that tension. Keep breathing. 3, 2, 1 and relax. Good. All right, we're going to stretch. If you have something to sit on, you can grab that. We'll go through a little standing portion first and then we'll sit. So let's follow me for a couple ones here. You can sit or stand. We're going to breathe in and breathe out. And breathe in and breathe out. One more. Breathe in and breathe out. All right, this time we're going to half fold. Breathe in. Hands go on your thighs. We half fold. And then up. Breathe in. Hands go on our thighs. We half fold. Breathe out. One more. Breathe in. Hands go on our thighs. We half fold. We slowly roll our body up and roll our shoulders back. Nice and steady. Good workout today. We got that full body going. Good. Bring one arm across your chest. Gently tug. Keep that shoulder nice and low. Couple deep breaths. Switch sides. Pull it across this way. Good. We're going to take both arms up, around, and back. Up, around, and back. Up, around, and back. Up, around, and back. We're going to take a big side reach. Couple deep breaths in and out. Stay tall. Don't slump with this side reach. Good. Switch sides. Up and over. Good. We're going to sit. We're going to stretch our hamstrings. We're going to scoot to the front edge of our chair. Bring our leg out nice and straight. Heel is down, toe is up. Leaning forward with a straight back, getting a good stretch behind our thigh. We'll take a few deep breaths. Good. We'll switch sides. Lean in, good medium stretch. Back is nice and straight. Try not to round. Couple deep breaths. Good. Then we're going to cross one leg over the other. Grab hold of your ankle if you need to. Gently press down on your knee and lean forward if you need it. Going to get a gentle stretch in your hip. Back is nice and straight. Grab your knee, pull it across towards your opposite shoulder. Stay tall here. Sit up tall. Get a good stretch in your tush. Good. Bring it down. Cross it over the other way. Gently press. Nice and tall. Grab your knee, pull it across towards your opposite shoulder. Good stretch in your tush. Good. Up nice and tall here. We're going to take our two deep breaths in together. We're going to breathe in and breathe out. And breathe in. And breathe out. Excellent workout today. Thanks so much for joining me.